Hi friends, this video is a short introduction to conditional prototyping in Figma. So we'll be making a small prototype where, as you can see, I have a very plain shopping experience with just one item, and I have a counter so I can add more items. And when I do that, you can see that the total number of items gets updated here, and that we also have our total cost in the button right here. And if I were to decrease the items, you can see that once I get to zero, my decrease button becomes disabled and I can no longer click on it. This button becomes disabled as well and I can't click on it either. But if we do have some items, you can actually click on this big button here, which takes you to your final checkout screen. So to get started, I'm going to jump into my blank worksheet. First, we're going to go over what I currently have. I have some prototype components, which are the button and then the decrease and increase button. None of them have any interactions just yet. And I also have my two screens, the shop screen and the checkout screen. For the text layers here, $5, the total amount and the total cost. These are just plain text layers and they're also not connected to any text content variables. So in terms of my local variables, I just have the colors here in the colors collection. And the first thing that we're going to do is create a different collection and I'll call it prototype. And in this collection, we're going to create a couple variables. The first one's going to be a number and it's going to be a price per bar. The second variable is going to be total bars. The last number variable is going to be total cost. Now I'm going to go and select the static number here and we're going to connect it to our price per bar variable. So now, as you can see, when I have it selected, I have this variable icon. I'm going to click on it and it changed to zero because currently the variable that I set it to is zero. So we can update it. We can do 5, we can do 8. Every time you update it, it's going to reflect it right here. Now I'm going to select the zero here and we're going to do the same thing and apply the total bars variable. The last thing we're going to do is select the zero in the button. And we're going to apply the total cost variable. Now we can add our first interaction, which is going to be when we click the plus button, we want to increase the number of bars and also update the total cost. So I'm going to go to our increase button component, then go to the prototype tab and add an interaction. So right now on tap, we want to change the action from none to set variable. And then the first variable that we're going to update is the total bars. And that's going to be our existing amount of bars. It could be 0, could be 1, 2, or more. So whatever the current amount is, and then we're going to add 1. Then in addition to setting our total bars, we also want to update the cost. So for that, we're going to once again do set variable. And the variable is going to be total cost, which again is going to equal to total cost plus price per bar. What we can do now is I'm going to select our shop frame and set it to preview. And now when I click plus, you can see that the number of bars gets updated and also the total cost gets updated in the button. So the next thing that we want to do is to make sure that we can decrease the number of bars and that also that once we start adding bars to our cart, that the decrease button and the big checkout button become enabled. First, for both of our big button here and the decrease button, they each have two variants, a disabled variant and an enabled variant. Let's actually move this one at the top so that they're ordered the same way. But now we're going to return to our local variables and we're going to create a boolean variable, which we'll call disabled, and we'll set it to true to begin. So now I'm going to return to our shop frame. I'm going to select the button, and now I have an option here to connect my variant to this variable. So I'm going to click this assign variable button, and I'll connect it to our disabled variable. So now what this means is that I can no longer modify the value from the properties panel, but I can control it through the variables panel. And the reason this is important is the fact that being able to control the behavior from the variables panel gives me greater control in the prototyping mode. Another reason is that I can reuse the single variable for different components. For example, we just applied it to our big checkout button, but we're also going to select this decrease button And we're going to do the same thing as well. So now, once again, I can change the disabled from true to false. And you can see that both of these buttons change their variants to enabled. Now that we have our Boolean variable, we can finish the prototype by adding the decrease function as well as navigating to the checkout screen. First, for our decrease button component, I'm going to add an interaction to the enabled variant. So we'll return to the prototype mode, add an interaction. The first action is going to be total bars, which is going to be equal to total bars minus one. Another interaction is going to be total cost, and the value will be total cost minus price per bar. Now, when we preview this, again, we have our adding functionality that we added at the beginning, and we're supposed to have our decrease functionality, but the problem is that we still can't access it because we have added it to the enabled variant of the decrease button, but our default variant is disabled. And the way we're going to update it now is I'm going to select our increase button, return to prototype, open our existing interaction, and we're going to add one more thing here, which is also going to be set variable. And the set variable is going to be the Boolean disabled variable, and we're going to set it to false. Now let's refresh our prototype. And so what should happen now is when I click plus, our disabled variable is set to true, which means that both the decrease button and the checkout button change their variants from disabled to enabled. So now I should be able to click on the decrease button and it should decrease the number of bars and decrease the cost. The only problem now is that I can keep on clicking this button and it's going to show me a negative number of bars and negative total cost. To fix that, we're going to go back to the decrease button, select our enabled variant. And for this interaction, we're going to add a conditional check. So here we're going to do check if else. And the condition is going to be is if total bars are greater than or equal to one. So we want to make sure that we have at least one bar in our cart. Then it means that we have bars to remove and that we can also update the total cost. Another check that we should do is that after we run these two commands, meaning we remove a bar and decrease the cost, we should check again to see if we now have zero bars, because if we now have zero bars, we want to set our Boolean variable back to true. So we're going to do another check, and the condition is going to be total bars equal to zero. And the action is going to be set the disabled Boolean variable to true. So now we're going to refresh. Let's add one bar. And then when we remove it, you can see that now our button goes back to disabled, both the decrease button and the big button, and that I can no longer click on them and we no longer get negative values. The last thing that we want to do is if we do have the checkout button enabled, we want to be able to click it to navigate to this final screen. So I'm going to select the enabled variant, add interaction, and you could probably just get away with selecting the navigate to and then the checkout. And it should work. But if you wanted to be extra careful, you can add the extra check, and the condition is just going to be checking whether disabled Boolean variable is equal to false, meaning that the button is enabled. And then we can navigate to that checkout screen. And actually, for our initial increment button, we could have added an extra check here just to see whether the disabled Boolean was set to true to begin with. Anyway, that's it for this prototype. Let me know if you would like to see more prototype tutorials. And also, if you're looking for more variable practice and you have not yet seen my other prototype on variables, feel free to check that one as well. It's a little bit different than this one, but is also more like beginner level. As always, thank you for watching, and until next time, bye.